Hi collectors, welcome back to my channel. Today we are looking at another studio series, Ratchet from Bumblebee Movie. Personally, I like the design of Transformer in Bumblebee Movie. They have more modern outlook and still we have the G1 feeling in the design. I actually very glad they finally released other characters from this movie besides Optimus and Bumblebee. So without further ado, let's just take a closer look on the box art. This is studio series Ratchet. Bumblebee movie logo at the top and a large open window at the front of the box. Autobot logo at the top and also nice artwork of Ratchet. This is deluxe class Ratchet and more close up artwork of Ratchet. We have some promote photo for Ratchet and we need 22 steps to transform. Hey Optimus, this is the Ratchet you talking about? Yes, that poor, finally we found him. Are you sure this is Ratchet?
Yes, I can confirm that.
But it looks different.
What? What do you mean different?
It looks different with Ratchet that I know.
So this is a Ratchet and he is green.
Yes, I am Ratchet. You see Optimus, we have another Ratchet and now he is in yellow.
Yes, I am also Ratchet.
Both of us are Ratchet. And now we have another Ratchet in box, but now he is in white.
Yes, Deadpool, we also have Ratchet in white.
Look at your bag. Hello Deadpool, I am also Ratchet and I also in white.
Oh man, I so confusing. Why Ratchet have so many color variants?
Here is our Ratchet out from the packaging and it actually looks good. But I'm still a bit disappointed on the figure. There are way too many holo on the figure. Normally we are expecting some holo at the side of the hand and side or back of the leg. But on this figure, we have more holo than what I expected. Besides those areas that I mentioned just now, they also have some minor holo at his back. And the most disappointed is, we have holo at the front on the thigh area. For years, we are complaining the holo on the figure, but looks like they totally not care about it. We get more and more holo on the figure now. They even can have holo at the front surface. Maybe the thin consumer will buy the figure as long as it is a famous character, regardless how bad the figure are. So let's us take a closer look on the figure and hopefully it is not as bad as I thought. Personally, I think this is a very nice Ratchet head sculpt. He has a very alien looking head sculpt. His faceplate painted in silver and the V-fin painted in red. We actually have light pipe pin here. Let's just try on the light pipe pin and it looks great to me. I like the design on its windshield, transparent blue plastic, separate in different parts. To me, the cockpit here really look like a cockpit for a spaceship. We have nice Autobot logo here, nice metallic red painted here, some van design here painted in gunmetal gray. A lot of surface detail at his back. But if we open the cover here, there are two hollow or empty inside its body. Nice red paint at his shoulder armor with a lot of surface detail on top of it. The joint is painted in gunmetal silver. Some grey detail touch up on his forehand. As usual, we have big holo at the side of his hand. Unfortunately, we have holo at the front surface at the thigh area. I actually hope at least they can cover the holo at the front area. At least it won't so obvious when we view from front. We have big holo at the side of the leg. A wheel here.
and also the fake wheel on the outer part of the leg. As usual, we have a big hollow here. Let me bring out our SS ratchet for simple comparison. As you can see, the SS ratchet are higher compared with Studio Series ratchet. The design of the cockpit are totally different. We have more spaceship look cockpit on our Bumblebee movie ratchet. As you can see, the design of both figures are totally different. The design on his hand area are different, as well as the leg area. And our SS ratchet are higher. As usual, we have long sheet of instruction manual. We have extra piece of cardboard to hold the figure. And also a nice backdrop, just like other Studio Series. I really like the graphic on this backdrop. His gun or blaster? The blaster is more in gunmetal silver plastic with a lot of surface detail on it. Full rotation at his head. Can slightly look up and slightly look down. Side to side pivot. His hand can up about 90 degrees. Full rotation, no problem. Single joint here can up about 90 degrees. Bicep rotation. No wrist rotation, but can hinge inward due to transformation. Waist rotation, he can split that much. Unfortunately, my ratchet have a very loose waist joint. Tight rotation, forward kick that much, and backward kick. Single joint here can bend about 90 degrees. Hinge joint at his foot can hinge inward and outward. Side to side pivot. Our ratchet is about 5 inch high. Here is our SS ratchet. Studio Series ratchet from Dark of the Moon movie. Also Studio Series ratchet from Transformer movie. SS Optimus Prime. SS Soundwave. Retro Megazord. Marvel Legend Doctor Strange in Multiverse of Madness. Defender Strange. Lightning Collection Trinoceros Sentry. And our Master Grey RX-78 Gundam.
Oh,
Personally, I really like the design on its cockpit. It really looks like a spaceship to me. The detail on the wheel looks good, and also a lot of surface detail on the vehicle. We have backlight sculpted here, and also some detail sculpted here. Unfortunately, we don't have any paint on it. His blaster can attach on the top of vehicle. After remove the blaster, you can see we have a lot of mechanical detail on top of the vehicle. At the bottom, Ratchet head is hidden here. Here is our Siege Ratchet in vehicle mode. Studio series Ratchet from Transformer movie. Siege Red Wing, Kingdom Cheetah, Studio Series Ravage, and last but not least, our Master Grade RX-78 Gundam. Overall, this is a very nice looking Ratchet. I really like this modern look Ratchet. Its cockpit really look like a spaceship cockpit, and I really like this type of design. The only downside is this figure are way too many hollow. Although I already expected some hollow on this figure, but I really disappointed when they have hollow on the front of his thigh area. Besides, the waist part on this figure are very loose. Overall, if you already immune with the hollow and also a fan of Ratchet, I still recommend this figure to you. This actually is a very nice looking Ratchet. Thanks for watching. Remember to come back to visit our channel again. We have more Transformer related video coming out soon. Here we keep playing, keep building, and keep dreaming. Ciao!